Hello everyone, this is Kate. I hope you're doing well. It's Monday, June 8th. This is a slightly different type of video for me because it's more of a story time type thing than the usual kind of content I do. I just wanted to share the story of how I came to be here at the airport. I'm actually waiting for a flight to the UK to be repatriated back to the UK. I'm recording this at Lagos Airport. So I arrived in Nigeria on March 8th. My husband and I certainly didn't intend to stay here for the length of time that we've been here. We had our plans, but like so many countless others, Corona, you know, put paid to those plans. So the story is this. I'm half Nigerian, so I come here quite frequently, but I always get pretty seriously ill. On this occasion, it's happened before. I've actually died medically and been revived. And it happened again this time, and we were told that, you know, I have no immunity to the falciparum parasite they have here, neither any immunity to the typhus. So if I get malaria here, if I get typhoid here, it will end my life. And so when we heard that, we realized that, you know, I had to leave the country as soon as possible. Of course, things happened, the airports closed down commercially. And so my husband and I didn't really know what we were going to do. So you won't know this, when I started my YouTube channel properly in early May, started uploading content and having an actual YouTube channel, in between uploading, recording conversations with Kate, dealing with people's questions and things like that, I was in hospital fighting for my life. It actually happened that the water in our building got poisoned. My husband was sick, my brother-in-law was sick, our neighbors got sick. So it's been a really harrowing time for us on top of everything that's going on. Anyway, my husband and I really thought about our plans and said, okay, the number one thing, priority is to get me back to the UK. And when we looked around, there was no way out. There was no real clear indication about when airports would be reopened, and airlines were really taking advantage with some of the prices they were charging. You know, some airlines were listing prices of sort of £8,000 one way to the UK and things like that. So it looked pretty harrowing. Late in May, my husband came across this thing that we didn't know about, which was these flights repatriating people back to the UK. Now, this had been going on for some time, and there was quite a considerable waiting list. So we applied and all the rest of it, right at the last minute, and registered at the last minute, just before your registration closed and all the rest of it, and just waited. For me, I was getting quite frustrated and fired off a couple of emails, but I felt calm within myself. And at that time, it was actually the time when my husband, right at the end of May, my husband was in hospital, when the story of Neville leaving the islands came to me. And I remember him talking about the fact that there were so many more people wanting to leave the islands than there was capacity to accommodate them. And even though there was a list as long as your arm, well, a mile long, Neville knew that he could look into the perfect law of liberty and put himself on the earliest ship possible and be returned to the United States. So he did that. He was in the dinghy with his daughter and his brother, I believe. He walked the gangplank. He felt the sway of the sea. He felt the spray of the sea, the salt of the sea air, that sort of thing. And so that's what I did. That story came to me so strongly after my histrionics were over and done with, and I began to do that. First, I put myself at Lagos Airport. I know the airport very well. I know what it looks like, I know what it smells like, I know what it sounds like. So I started with that, but I didn't get that sense of relief that I was looking for. And so I thought, okay, I have to go to the UK. So I need to put myself in my living room, in the kitchen, making tea in my favorite mug. I need to see my neighbor, say hello to him and his wife and the children, and see the post box or the local supermarket. And I didn't just see these things as pictures in my head. I saw them subjectively, which means I saw them using the eyes of my body of consciousness, or the sight, the vision of my body of consciousness. I smelt things subjectively. I tasted things, I touched things, I heard things. And I continued doing this until I felt that relief, that, you know, things that helped, my parents' voice, the voice of my nieces and nephews, those sorts of things. All of that, the sounds, the sights, it became so real, so intense to me. And I persisted in that until I felt that yes, it had happened. And so even though we came in at the 11th hour, once I felt that relief, I think it was a day later, it was certainly Saturday, 1 a.m., I got an email saying, Catherine, you are on the flight on Monday. And I am aware of the fact that there are very, very many people who have been waiting since April. And so when I was looking at the kind of comments that people were making on social media, what I started to do was really pray for them, intend that decisions about things being final would be changed, that they would have the money they needed to sustain themselves, that they would be healthy, that they would be able to, their mental faculties would stay, you know, intact until they're able to return home. So that's what I did. I was able to pray for other people waiting to go home, that they can return home as soon as possible. But as for me, I just wanted to use this story to encourage you. I do what I do, I say what I say because of my life experience. And I want to encourage you to look at any challenge you're facing right now as an opportunity to strengthen your subconscious powers. That's what they're for. The purpose of our traumas, the purpose of our challenges, is to give us an opportunity to use our subjective senses to strengthen the communication between who we actually are and our human aspect or our human expression, until we reach the point where we are actually living exclusively by consciousness. When you do that, your life is elevated to an entirely different level. So yeah, I had my little wobble, but the moment I put that down, which was very silly and time consuming, and focused on doing what I needed to do, doing what I needed to do, I was able to achieve the result I wanted. Using the spiritual language of emotion, I told consciousness that I needed to be home in the UK, and I was given passage less than 2 days ago. And you know, I did those activities that I'm telling you about, that I described, just a couple of days before that, and I persisted until I felt that relief. And I want this story to encourage you. Use what you know. This is a manifestation. Even in the queue today at the airport, hearing people just absolutely heartbroken about what's happened to people they know, the fact that they themselves have had to wait since April. And I'm not saying this to say, ha ha, I got one over on them. No, I'm saying that we all have this available to us. That for people who are left behind in these sorts of situations, to say, okay, they may have said no more flights, but you can say, yeah, there will be another flight, because this flight wasn't available at first. I said to my mom, you know what, it's like they put this flight on just for me, because at the time of the other flights, my husband was in hospital, so it was impossible for me to go, but I needed to go back. And they put another flight on, even though they said there weren't going to be any other flights. And funnily enough, when I got to the airport, there was a queue. I waited at my turn, but when we went inside, I was just being ushered about by staff and taken here and taken there and brought to the gate and, you know, processed through first class, even though there isn't any first class on the flight. Given that treatment, because this is the impression that was made on consciousness. And so I want you to really avail yourself of these same gifts that you have. See your challenges as an opportunity to use your power and get the results that you want. I wish you all a wonderful day ahead, and I can't wait to see you all again in the next upload.